How are great leaders made? Are there questions that have no answers?
Are there answers that need no questions?
You see, I was watching John F. Kennedy give a speech after the assassination of Martin Luther King in Indianapolis. And I remember him just one moment in that speech, just looking back and looking at the people, and I'm pretty sure his state of consciousness, how he was looking at reality, was he was thinking as humanity. He was like, this is pretty fucked up for human beings, right? And he says this very beautiful statement, and I can say that I think he's one of the greatest speakers I've ever seen. He says, and he's quoting this from something he's heard the Greeks say, to tame the savageness of man and make gentler the life of this world. Can you visualize this human being, this president of a nation, standing in front of people, other beings, communicating the vision that he sees that was passed on to tame the savageness of man and make gentler the life of this world? There was an intensity communicated there where I understood that we are keeping ourselves limited. When one man can lead all men, he is an example that all men can get to that state. And so regardless of the intentions of governance, man has always been inspired by the challenges of this world. You should live in a way where you are, your mind is not creating unnecessary enemies behind doors. You must immediately walk in your clarity, sincerity, honesty, and just follow your natural knowing. For how you tame the savageness of man, perhaps, and make gentler the life of this world, is that you see, as long as the imagery of taming savageness is present, beings will learn from it. As long as the acts are still being done, humanity is not finding its uttermost clarity. What that means is, you may think you have lived for yourself, but you have always lived for humanity. You have lived for life, for you are life. And how you make gentler the life of this world is to move, and perhaps the seers of the Greeks at that time saw that they realized this world needs to go into gentleness, for then there is an allowance of greater vision. And what that means is, if you're trying to watch a movie and suddenly thousands, like 10 people suddenly are beginning to coming in front of you and walking around and you can't see the TV screen, you'll be, gosh, this world is so savage. You know, we need to tame man. But as you begin to simply see that reality as it is, those people are doing their things, and sometimes the people you wonder why they're so cruel to you have no idea how you are looking. And you wonder, what is this reality where voices can be spoken but cannot be heard? But you will begin to see in the greatest paradoxes of life, it is that moment where the mystic has gone into the cave, he has gone into the cocoon of the earth, and through a transcendental metamorphosis of an observance of mind and body simultaneously present among all that abstraction could be, the divine was present in objectivity, for objectivity was conscious that it was never objective. What that means is, you may jump in a swimming pool, and you will go underwater and feel that reality, but you always know you can step out. And trust me, there's fresh air. I think human beings have a great capacity to guide their fellow man, but they must first be aware of their capacity, of what is within them.
You must confront aspects of yourself that will sometimes make you look like a sinner and aspects of yourself that sometimes make you look like a saint. And you must walk between these worlds. What that means is perhaps when it was suggested that some beings walked on water, they walked on the water of reality, on the fluidity of how temporal how temporal form is. We're beginning to see it wave, and sometimes it seems to be a bit too particular for a wave. But we must allow a vision that is not postulating from an objective limitation, because that could be dangerous. Because belief was also a banner which you had to carry, and if you carry too many banners, you'll be like, what am I doing? This is heavy. And you'll probably let go of the sense of self, and sometimes you might not let go. Sometimes life will come and make you drop it. Because there have been moments where I have told myself I wanted to be something in a certain way, and I have seen life guide me totally out of that direction to another sense of clarity, that it's as if when you are not honest with yourself, you're not giving this world a chance to be honest with you. When you're not being loving with yourself, you're not giving this world a chance to be loving to you. For from self originates the greatest conception of other. For how could there be a speaker without an audience? In the blessings that is man's natural understanding, we have flown beyond directives that needed shape to be satisfied in a certain way. Humanity is realizing not that only you can see the beauty of this reality from one path, but there are many paths up this mountain. However, man must immediately go to the peak. Humanity must be the peak, and there must be such a flow of natural play of expression that you will begin to see it's as if there is never the concept of work leaves, and we are always an awareness to all transition. So it's a very graceful sense of being, but of course right now the way man receives it is like a treasure map that is only a mirror. John F. Kennedy displayed in that video I saw on YouTube a moment of clarity for humankind, a moment of existential allowance and love for humankind. What that means is you must not think of trying to be kind. Oh no, it's not about trying to just everybody go do good things. It's about you seeing that that was a given. Our task is here to create a multidimensional renaissance. We must already have established love in humanity as nature of being. For how else is humanity going to learn from the communications that come from its greater development? For that moment, man is confronted by the greatest challenges, whether it comes from technology beginning to design us, or it's our naturally timed dissolution and transition out of physicality. Honored by life, we are guided by the transcendental presence. What that means, if you see your idea as a visitor to this world, just your idea, just your unique sense of who you are in present here, as a unique visitor in this world, you will begin to see your uniqueness could not be touched. What that means is there is nothing weird about life moving. Weirdness occurs from the incapability of an audience to be aware beyond ideology. And the only way man, not the only way, but the most effective way and most very quickest way man can do it is through a sense of compassion, but an existential compassion that is innately present within you. It is here. And as many have said, now.
To tame the savageness of man and make gentler the life of this world.
Live for life and you shall see life.
Much blessings, namaste.